Hi everyone, welcome to Without a Clue WarGaming. Tom here. About to do a video that I never, ever, ever thought I would do, which is a painting guide on my World Eaters scheme. I do not rate myself as a painter, let me say that right up front. I think I'm distinctly average when it comes to painting, but I've had comments from people saying they like the way my World Eaters look, asking a few questions here and there about how I get the effect that I have, so I figured what the hell, let's do one. So what I have here is one of the Burning of Prospero Marines. I'm going to be using these as augmented inductile, which means I'm keeping them to quite a simple paint job, but the concept's the same. You can use these as your tacticals or what have you. So all he's had is a blowover with Corax White. I know some people don't like the Corax White, I personally really do. It dries really quickly and I think it gives a really nice effect. So, things you're going to need, obviously I've got my brushes here, water, some tissue, a sponge, which we'll come to. I will make sure I tell you what every single paint I use. I do use a mixture of army painter and citadel paint, excuse me, for most of my miniatures, although the army painter colors I'm going to be using are gunmetal, matte black, and they're soft tone. So obviously Agrax Earthshade you can replace that with, Lead Belcher, and I believe it's a Baden Black. So yeah, up to you. So what you're going to need to do first of all is wash the Marine to actually give him some detail and definition in his armour. So what I use is Null Oil, Drakenhof Nightshade, and Lamia Medium. It's quite simple, this recipe. It basically goes on eye. So you just need to mix up equal parts, and I'm only going to try and do a tiny bit of this because obviously I'm only doing one marine. Usually I would make up a big bulk of this and do lots at once. Okay, and then the Lamia Medium. Okay, then what you need is a very old brush that you don't care about to mix all of this together. This is a brush that has rock hard, so I just use it as a mixer. There you go, so it's like that. Now what I use for doing the wash is this giant brush. Now like I've said, I am not a pro painter, I don't claim to be a pro painter. I know there'll be people saying, how dare you use such a giant brush, you should use small detail brushes, things like that. This is the way I've done it, so that's the way I'm going to show you. So you get some of this. You can look at it on your mat and you should get, like, it's a very light bluish grey. That's the colour you're looking for. Okay, so we literally slap it on the entire marine. Okay, this is quite a dirty effect I go for. I know some people that do World Eaters, they really love like a crisp, clean white. Personally, I like them to look grubby and dirty and like they've gone through hell and they're still ripping people to pieces. So I've literally just covered it. I'll give it a quick blow and it will go into all of the little gaps. So in his helmet, the backs of his legs, in the fingers, everywhere like that. Okay, really, really simple, really, really quick. So I'm gonna put him down and in Blue Peter fashion, I'm going to say, here's one I made earlier. Actually, I'm going to do this one. Okay, so that one is one I washed earlier on today. The wash does take a little while to dry, hence why I've had one already made. So what you can see, I hope you can see anyway, because I can't see what the camera can see, it goes into all these grooves, into the backpack, into the face mask. It just adds definition on the white and it just makes it look a lot nicer of a complete product. So the next thing is Cantor Blue. Now again, people have different ways of doing this. Some people go for a dark blue, some people go for a very light blue. I personally like the dark blue. I'm just going to dry that off so there's none of it on there. Yes, so Cantor Blue. Now, before anyone comments the inevitable meme, thin your paints, I subscribe to the old-fashioned way of doing things where I just dip my brush in my water, which is just off camera. Just get stand up and check. There we go. So, yep. That's how I thin my paints. So I just dip it in a little piece of water, and there we go. So, on this model, we need insides of the shoulder pads, the top vents, and that's it in blue. If you're doing veterans or something, obviously you can add more blue, more brass. I'm keeping these really simple and quick. So, I've got my bit of tissue here, a little bit of Cantor blue, and there we go. You can be quite lax with it. If it goes onto the outside, it's not the end of the world. You're going to be covering it up with brass anyway, although obviously the neater you are now, the easier it is later on. It always needs two coats, this as well, I found, so don't worry about getting maximum coverage. Okay, get it in there. Make sure you're right up to the edge where you're going to go brass. There we go. And I've done what I always do when I start painting. I forget the bit I've done and I put my finger on it. Okay, then the outlets on the back. So again, just get the Cantor blue all the way around. Obviously, I'm going to put silver in the actual output of the vent. And make sure you get underneath, because while I'm not the best painter in the world, I do like to be able to pick up one of my miniatures, look at it and say, yes, it's all painted, everything that I wanted to be painted is painted. So put that down there, let the blue dry off. While that's happening, I'm going to use some Warpstone Glow for the eyes. Now, some people do eyes red on World Eaters. Personally, I do them green because I put the blood on. If you've seen any of my videos with my World Eaters army on the complete painted stuff, I use blood for the blood god quite liberally, let's put it that way. So I go for the green eyes just because I like it to stand out a little bit. So, give that a quick shake. Little bit of water on the brush, nice little bit of Warpstone green, and I'm hoping you can all see this. I have got shaky hands. It's not because I'm filming, I am just not a very steady-handed person. So there we go, Warpstone green, his eyes are done. Sometimes you need two coats of that, sometimes you don't, so we'll wait and see how it looks. Now, obviously I don't want to go start sticking more blue on while that is still drying. So what I will do now is go on to the black. So, matte black, I really like the Army Painter paints because they come in these dropper bottles. I know some people hate the dropper bottles, but yeah, a bad and black if you don't have it. So I've already wet my brush before I started, and then I just do the casing of the bolter. I do try to leave the bits that are going to be silver unpainted, but the silver, what's it called, gunmetal, or obviously the lead belcher if you use in Citadel, it is quite a strong, heavily pigmented silver, so you will get away with just painting the silver over the top. So the handle, everything around the gum, just making sure I haven't missed anything. Now again, I know some people will be looking at me saying, what the hell is he doing? Why has he glued the guns on? My very first Marines, in fact, I probably never said this on a video, I started playing Tabletop War Games when I was about 11 years old, my cousin got into Epic and Space Hulk and things like that, and I used to go and stay there during the summer holidays. Obviously, you know, my parents couldn't have 6 weeks off work to look after me, so I'd go up there, stay with my aunt and uncle, and I started playing Epic and things like that. And then after that, when I was about 14, maybe 13 years old, I got, along with my younger brother, I believe it was the third edition of 40K. It was the first one that I actually owned. I'd played second, again with my cousin, but I bought the starter box, which was Dark Elder versus Space Marines. I quite cruelly forced my younger brother to play as Dark Elder, which is probably why he's never really got into the hobby. It was an incredibly unbalanced starter box. Anyone that started that, you got 20 Dark Elder Warriors against 10 Space Marines and a Land Speeder. And of course, in those days, before hull points and things like that, the only way the Dark Elder, at least that were with the sprues you got in that box, so I'm just doing the chainsaw black as well, you would have to use a splinter cannon, which was strength 4 in those days. It was before all of the funky poison rules for Dark Elder, and you would then have to immobilize, because you could only get a glance, so the best result you could get was an immobilize, which actually, as it was a skimmer, would destroy it. So you needed 4 to hit, then a 6, then another 6 to stop the Land Speeder, which of course I just put a heavy bolter on and flew around killing his warriors willy-nilly. So yeah, apologies to my brother if he's watching this, for forcing him to be the Dark Elder in those days. Anyway, so black onto the chainsword. I'm also going to do the handle black. I'm gonna put a little bit of brown on it later on. I like the kind of leather effect, but fundamentally black is the color I use for all my World Eater weapons. So there we go. So he's drying out a little bit more. Okay, clean my brush. Next thing I'm going to need, excuse me, very crass, is a little more of the Cantor blue. The pads and everything have now dried off, so you can put that second coat on. I've never needed to do more than two coats with the Cantor blue. Again, it's quite a heavily pigmented color, so one done, the other side. Yeah, so anyway, so yes, so that's what I'm saying, and that is why I stick the bolters on anyway, is the end of that story. It's the way I learned to do it, and it's the way I've always done it. And I'm fully aware that I could leave them off, I could pin things, I could do that, but I am a creature of habit, so there we go. So I continue to do it the way I've always done it, and I've just realized I've splashed some black onto his helmet, but that's fine because that'll work quite nicely as a little bit of battle damage. Okay, so bolt gun's done, the outside anyway. Second layer's done on the shoulder pads. So what I'm going to start doing is just touching over the black on the chainsaw, just to make sure it's a nice, deep, rich black colour. Being very careful not to put my fingers where I've already painted. Just another quick go over on the bolt gun. There we go. Okay, so give that a couple of seconds to just dry before I start doing anything else. Apologies if the camera's wobbling. While that's drying, I have washed a lot of models tonight. I've also done, if you saw my army update, everything that was white on that army update has now been washed. So I'm feeling fairly confident I can start making some real progress getting these models ready. So next thing is the gunmetal or the lead belcher if you're using Citadel paints. It's already well shaken before I started filming. I personally think the gunmetal is a slightly nicer metallic shade, although if you put completely painted models, one done with one with the other next to me, I'd probably embarrass myself and not be able to tell the difference. But I personally think when it goes on, I prefer the gunmetal to the lead belcher. But yeah, it's much of a muchness, to be honest. So what I'm doing is just the outputs, and then I'm also going to do the little fan on the back and the surround to that. Now I oomed and ahed about the tubes. I'm actually going to leave the tubes white because I want them to look like they're in armor that hasn't been bothered to be painted up fully, because they are just going to be in ductile. Obviously you could do the tubes, so I'll just do the insides of the inlets to the backpack, just around the edge as well. All done, and we can also start to put the silver on the bolt gun, so the magazine. The switch on the side, I always put some silver on. I'm going to put a little bit on this little section here, just make this bare metal. There you go. Then the final bit that needs doing is, of course, the barrel. You do need a little bit of a steady hand for that, because you're going down underneath the hand. Tip of the barrel. Make sure the back side's done as well. I'll also do the rear of the magazine while I've got it here, and the bottom. Okay. And the other thing I do silver is the base of the handle. I'm not sure if you can see that, but I like that to be bare metal as well. And just a little touch in there. Now, next thing I do, dry the brush off, and I simply dry brush a little silver line across there, little silver line across there, just touch the sight, top of the gum, down the side there. Just a little bit of wear on the top of the bolter. Next, the chainsword. I mean, you could go really elaborate, of course, with these chainsaws. You could put all brass and everything on them. Like I say, I'm keeping these simple. This is meant to be stuff that's just been forged to be given to these individuals. So it's having a nice simple silver, and obviously the chain itself. If I can find, I don't actually mind if I spill over a little bit with the chain, because it just, it adds a little wear pattern. I think it's I like it to look used and abused. I mean, if you see my Blood Angels, I know I'm trying to keep it fluffy as Fifth Company, but whew, I don't know, I think even Fifth Company would have been slightly ashamed to be quite that badly beaten up with their equipment. So there we go. So, bolt gun's done, eyes are done, everything's now drying off. So we're left with the brass, the blood, and the leather. Well, I've just realised the handguard, which I wanted to be silver, I'd missed, so let's just get that done. Okay, I just realised I haven't got my brown paint out, which is a little bit silly of me. I've got a horrible feeling actually I might have run out, so that's gonna put a slight delay getting this done properly. Soft tone, white gunmetal. Believe it or not, I have run out of my brown leather army painter paints. I'm gonna have to get some more. So, what would be brown leather on this model? You've got a strap that holds the chainsword on. That will be brown leather. Anyone that's got any pistol holsters, pouches for magazines and things like that, I always do them in brown leather. But yeah, so actually what I might do, I might be tempted to do it in brass. That could be quite interesting. Like a brassed strap for the weapon. Just doing some touch-ups. No, do you know what? I'm going to stick with my original plan. I am going to do that in brown, but I'll have to order up some more of the leather paint, which I really, really like, if I'm honest with you. Just noticed the outside of this little fan, which I also want to be silver. Little blow, just make sure the paint's all even. Okay, there we go. So we go on to the brass, and for this I use Rune Lord brass, circle layer paint. It needs a massive shake, this stuff. It really splits. Let's have a look. Yeah, perfect. It's to a nice consistency. It also, look, I mean, look at this. You lose most of the paint from the flipping stuff that dries on the pot. It's a very, very viscous and thick paint, this one. So, pick some of that up. And we just edge all of the shoulder pads all the way around. Again, it's one of those, if you make a slight mistake, you can touch it up. You know, I'm a, like I say, I've not got the steadiest hand, so I'm quite used to going over and touching up once or twice everything to make sure it's all even. And making sure to get the inside as well, that you can see, and the underneath. Now, sometimes I found this needs two coats. I'm also going to do the base of the chainsword. And you know what? I'm going to put just a little brass highlight on there as well. Yeah, I've never really worked out what causes it to need two coats. Whether it's that I don't mix it well enough, although I do always shake it to oblivion. Sometimes it seems to go on perfectly with one coat. Other times it just kind of separates out again. This pot, since I've been using it, doesn't seem to be doing that. So perhaps it was, first one maybe was a slightly older pot. It had been sat in a warehouse and just wasn't to its best. I don't know. But anyway, underneath, sure the inside is done as well. Okay, so there we have the almost completed when it comes to the basic colors marine. Now tricks that I have picked up, which I probably should talk about. Like I say, not a good painter, but I've learned spending the time to get the wash adds the detail. Keeping paint schemes simple, actually, I think is really important. I think people often are so desperate to do something clever and over the top that they don't actually stick to their skill level. You know, I know where my skill lies and I know my limits, so I don't try to do things that are beyond those. And you could, I suppose, argue that that holds me back, stops me from making progress. But at the same time, I would turn around and say, well, I have, you know, a couple of fully painted armies that I'm more than happy to put on the table. So, yeah, just going to go over these little tiny bits of brass that have spilled into the blue. Perfect. Perfect. And now I've got to do the opposite because I've gone too far the other way. Okay. Tiny bit of brass just to cover up my foolishness there. There we go. So he's almost done. There we go. So what I'm waiting to do now is the washes. I'm not going to wash the blue of the shoulder pads simply because I'm waiting to put the transfers on. I've got 4 jaw transfers. I'm going to do those all at one time at the end. Saves yourself a lot of time. One of those bits are drying. I'm just going to neaten up the wear on the chainsaw. Little bit of black just to take that silver down a little bit. Don't want it to look like it's too beaten up. Don't think a World Eater Sergeant would take too kindly to that. I have also now made the rash decision to make this strap black. And I'm glad I did, because I really like that. There is a cat coming up to see me, so if a cat suddenly jumps on the table, I apologise. So yeah, so that's going to dry off. So what you're going to need for the final stage while that's drying, so let me check. Wow, long video. Is some Nuln oil. Some soft tone or Agrex Earthshade, they're pretty much identical. And blood for the blood god, the technical paint. So, soft tone, I think I just called it this, but talent in a bottle, as it's known. You just stick this over the silver. So, sections that have already dried. In the blade of the chainsaw and the motor. All over the bolt gum. Splash it on liberally would be my advice in these outputs. On this back part that we've done. Beautiful. Okay. And then finally, a bit of the Nuln oil. Some people would use the Agrex for this part as well. I personally think the Nuln oil is a little bit better because it takes the metallic down a little bit more. And just put a little bit of that on the brass. Let it go where it wants to go. And yeah, it just dirties them up, scums them up a little bit. There we go. And he is done with the basic painting. So the last thing we have to do is my blood effect. So for that you need blood for the blood god and a sponge. I steal these from my wife. So you just literally dab it on, drip it off on a piece of dry tissue, and literally you just go over the miniature in places where blood may splatter. So on his wrists, across his helmet, backpack, a little more, a little bit on the chainsaw, a little bit on that side, and there we have it. One World Eater Tactical Marine, 29 to go. Yeah, so that's how I do them. It's quick, it's dirty, but it's tabletop ready, and I like the way they come out. Please like and subscribe if you enjoy what we're doing. We've got the competition obviously running at the moment. When we pick up 500 subscribers, 1,000 subscribers, we're going to be giving away a Space Marine Rhino. And also like our Facebook page, because we've got a competition going on there to win one of our new Without a Clue Wargaming mugs, which might not seem like the coolest prize in the world. It's not models, granted, but they are very cool, and they're obviously awesome for using for water cups for when you're painting. So yeah, like, subscribe, comment, all that good stuff, and I'll see you soon. Thanks.